together. All I know, love will save the day.
Rauner, and on behalf of the entire University of Illinois system, our 83,000 students, I'm deeply grateful to you for your unwavering support of innovation as a pathway to progress, and for your confidence in us, in the University of Illinois system, to lead this game-changing initiative. And thanks to all of you for joining us this morning, beautiful morning. Before I get started, there are a few guests I would like to recognize. Please hold your applause until I've read their names, and I apologize ahead of time. I think there are more people here than we might have been expecting, but we have the Vice President of Research and Special Assistant for Government Affairs, Bruce Layton, from Northwestern University, one of our two inaugural partners in DPI. We have John Flavin, Associate Vice President for Entrepreneurship and Innovation and Head of the Polsky Center at the University of Chicago, our other inaugural partners. There are more partners to come, I assure you, but we're so proud of that Northwestern University of Chicago are joining with us, the University of Illinois system, and we're together unstoppable. We have Senate Minority Leader Bill Brady and House Republican Leader Jim Durkin. We had Representative Kelly Burke, who chairs the House Education Committee in the State House of Representatives. I believe she had to leave us. We have Chicago Alderman Daniel Solis, whose 25th ward will be the home of DPI. We have Ramon Cepeda, a member of our Board of Trustees and a graduate of the University of Illinois at Chicago. We have Don Edwards, another member of our board and a graduate of the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign. Don is also CEO of FlexPoint Ford, a private equity investment firm he founded in 2005, and he will talk about the impact of these initiatives later in our short program. We have several CEOs of major corporations in the audience, Pat Canning of KPMG, we have Scott Swanson of PNC Illinois, we have Michael Tipsord, State Farm, and we have Jim Roth of Huron, and there may be others, and so it's wonderful to see the vibrant connection with business leadership here this morning to help us with the celebration of this announcement. So please join me in thanking all of them for their support and their service to the people of the state. And please join me in another much deserved and special thank you to Kurt Bailey and Related Midwest for their generous donation of the land that will be home to this historic and to be famous Discovery Partners Institute. DPI will showcase the critical role that great research universities play in a knowledge-based 21st century economy, where discovery and innovation are more powerful and needed than ever. The unique new innovation center will add to the momentum that's been growing rapidly here in Chicago through 1871, Matter, M-Hub, and other incubators to really build out the innovation infrastructure that is now so crucial to create new businesses and new jobs. DPI will deliver a high-powered jolt, yes, a jolt, at the kind of scale that can massively accelerate job creation and economic development. And we're all in. DPI will bring well over 100 of the world's top best research faculty and staff to Chicago, where they will work closely with world-class researchers who already call the U of I system and our partner institutions home. So we're talking about hundreds of pioneering researchers. Together, they will target research to address our most pressing challenges, from cybersecurity to new life-saving drugs, to breakthroughs in agriculture, to feed an ever-growing world. Their visionary scholarship, we believe, will attract $500 million in new research funding annually and foster discovery to turn ideas that once were beyond our imagination into the kind of job and economy building businesses of tomorrow that's worthy of this world city and this great state. Researchers will also work side by side with companies large and small from across Chicagoland, providing their expertise to solve real world challenges and grow their businesses. They will also work side by side with students, and that's what it's all about for us, frankly, our students. About 1,800 a year when DPI reaches full operation, nurturing the inventors and the entrepreneurs of tomorrow. During their 1 to 4 semesters here at DPI, our students will also work with businesses across Chicago, honing their talents and helping plant roots to halt or slow down an out-migration of graduates to other states. In fact, we want to turn those arrows around towards Illinois. And like its research, DPI will provide those opportunities on a really unprecedentedly large scale. Nearly 10,000 students every 5 years when the new institute reaches full operation. DPI will build on a long relationship between the U of I system and Chicago that has been blossoming for well over a century. Chicago is an ideal location for the new institute because of its role as an economic engine for the Midwest, and because its place as a global destination will help attract top faculty, students, and businesses from around the world. And we believe, and I hope you agree, that the U of I system is an ideal partner to lead DPI. We have a long, rich legacy of discovery and innovation. Governor Rauner has mentioned some of that in each of the key areas that will be the initial focus of DPI's research, from our world-class computing and agriculture programs in Champaign to cutting-edge healthcare and engineering here at UIC, which one can see just over my shoulder. And we have a long history of partnerships with universities and businesses across the state and around the world to ensure that we always keep reaching higher to better serve students, innovation, and the public good. DPI is just part of today's announcement. The new institute will also build on the U of I system's bedrock commitment to serve every corner of Illinois. This is the Abe Lincoln land grant mission, as you all know. It will be, though, the centerpiece of a virtually connected statewide enterprise that we're creating called the Illinois Innovation Network. The network will connect DPI's researchers with university and business partners in other regions, fostering innovation that will lift communities across our state. Together, DPI and the Innovation Network are a springboard that will help Illinois lead the way in an era that will redefine the seeds of progress and economic growth. And I'm deeply grateful to everyone who has helped bring this next generation vision to life. Now it's my great honor to introduce another incredible supporter of discovery and innovation, Mayor Rahm Emanuel. Mayor Emanuel is committed to making the city a hub where the world turns to see what's coming next. We hope to add to that storyline. Under his leadership, the city has developed a thriving ecosystem that supports young startups as much as global corporate headquarters. Please join me in welcoming Mayor Rahm Emanuel.
Cubs win, sun's out. Coincidence? I think not. Thank you, President Killeen, and thank you all for being here. Thank you, Governor, for leading this effort, not only to this point, but going forward in making this a reality. I would say also like to note that for 4 years in a row, the city of Chicago is the number one city for corporate relocations in the United States of America. For 5 years in a row, the city of Chicago is the number one city for direct foreign investment in the United States of America. And for 6 years in a row, the city of Chicago's economy has grown faster than New York, D.C., or the United States of America. Now, I don't think it's my winning personality that made that possible. It's because we have what I view as what I always call the five T's and invest in that strategy. Talent, training, transportation, technology, and transparency. We have more universities than any other city in the United States, but Boston. And when you draw a radius around the city of a couple hundred miles, more type of level one universities than any other city, not only in the United States, but the world. And the biggest thing holding back the city of Chicago and the state of Illinois was the 200 to 300 miles between Chicago and Champaign. We just narrowed that today. And the fact, I see this, now I obviously have, I'm for Illinois, but I really, really am for Chicago. And I see this as a big win for the city of Chicago and a big loss for the West Coast. And I'm proud of the fact that we've come together and saw what we all know is important for the city of Chicago and for the state of Illinois, that we're tired of being the intellectual and research foundation for everything else that then gets moved back. Now, in the preceding years, in the last couple of years, and a classic example when the governor's right about what about PayPal, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, PayPal then moved out west. 3 years ago, they bought Braintree here in the city of Chicago and have expanded from a couple hundred jobs to 800 jobs because of the talent that's here in the city and the capacity with the broadband network and the capacity of our research universities to actually do what we need to do and our ability in the center of the country to get anywhere in the world, anywhere in the United States, anywhere in North America, any time of day, multiple times a day, weather permitting, and we're working on that in City Council, Danny and I. This is a tremendous building effort that builds on a strong foundation and takes it to the next level. Not far, the University of Chicago in Argonne now is working on the next battery research. Later this year, Northwestern will open up the new biomedical research center for the city of Chicago. And a short time from now, IIT will be opening up the Kaplan Research Center. These intellectual foundations are the beginning and the next effort, not only for corporations, the next ideas that will create the new companies that will take Chicago, the economy, to another level. And with our capacity, both intellectually, economically, and culturally, the world will come to Chicago to discover what's next. To everybody that's part of this day, it's one moment on a milestone. Not only do I look forward to this announcement, but more importantly, to what comes from this. And a closing remark, I would also like to say, I think what's also important is something else. That is, you know, Chicago Public High School students today lead the country in graduation growth of all urban systems. We also lead the United States of America, and kids going from high school to college and now match the national average, even though 85% of our kids are from poverty or below, beating New York, LA, and Dallas. And the good news with this research institute, they won't have to go somewhere else to be part of the future. They'll just go take a train stop away and be part of that future. So thank you for making that possible.
All right, well, thank you very much, everyone. This is an exciting day. A lot of hard work ahead of us, but let's be crystal clear. We have the opportunity with this Discovery Partners Institute and this Illinois Innovation Network across the state of Illinois to bring hundreds of thousands of new jobs to the state of Illinois. Hundreds and hundreds of thousands of new jobs. Transforming Illinois' economy. Now, why can I say that with confidence? Here's something you may not know. We graduate here, the U of I and some of our other universities, 10% of all of America's computer scientists. Think about that. 10% of America's computer scientists are graduated here in the state of Illinois, led by the University of Illinois. Where does Microsoft get their computer talent and their executives? U of I. What can we do? What do we have the opportunity to do here, starting with this? Drive a massive new retention, massive new magnet to retain our computer scientists, to keep our students and faculty here building their businesses by getting them in the ecosystem here in the city of Chicago, here in Urbana-Champaign, here in Rockford, world-class aerospace manufacturing, here in Peoria, world-class heavy equipment advanced manufacturing, here in Decatur, world-class bioprocessing and advanced food and food sciences. Keeping our scientists here, getting them integrated in a network that the Illinois Innovation Network itself is going to create, drive massive growth, retention of the talent, and we're going to knock down the barriers, the regulatory hurdles, the non-compete agreements, the royalties, the fees, the limitations. The attitude is, you've got an idea, or you did research and you came up with a new product idea, it's yours, go build a business, no restrictions, no strings attached, build a business in Illinois and go on to wonderful success. It's beyond anything we've ever contemplated before in the state. Transforming Illinois' economy, led by one of the greatest universities in the world, U of I, partnering with two of the other greatest universities, UFC, where we're gonna go this afternoon and talk about another joint venture with the U of I and UFC there, as well as Northwestern, and over time, IIT and NIU and ISU and Southern Illinois University in Carbondale. We are blessed with some of the greatest research institutions in the world. If we network, integrate the research and the faculty and the students, drive innovation and push company formation here in the state of Illinois, the sky's the limit. Unlimited potential for the people of Illinois. An exciting time. Thank you for all being out today. Let's go on to great success. Thank you very much, everybody.
Hey, how you doing?
I know.